All right, there goes the Mariner. She's out of here.
So hey you guys, welcome back to the channel. So, the Mariner's gone. What did we make on it? Stay tuned, later in the video we'll go over some numbers. For now, we're heading back to the auction. We're gonna see what we can get out there. Hopefully we'll find something this time. We're gonna go out to the Route 66 Auto Auction. That is in El Reno, Oklahoma. That's about 20 minutes west of OKC. Let's go out there and see if we can find something. So here we go. We got it for $1,000 was the winning sale price with a $110 buyer fee. So we're $1,110 out the door on this one. It is an 08 Chevy Uplander. All right, she fired up. Now the miles is a little high on this one. We're at 264,000 miles, but $1,100. I mean, there's got to be a little bit left on it, right? She sounds great. All right, we went right into gear. All right, I'm going to shut it off, check the fluids, and then we're out of here. Actually, it looks pretty decent. It's not black. Awesome. Check the fuel on this thing. Got coolant in it. And it looks clean, too. So, alright, we're going to get this one out the gate. Moment of truth. Let's see if she drives or how she drives. We know it drives. It went through the auction, right? Let's see if she's roadworthy. Show the gate, my paperwork, and we'll be on our way. Which one of these you need? This one?
Big one.
All right.
We're gonna put you on YouTube if you don't want to see.
We got her.
Gotcha.
All right.
right. Appreciate you guys. Yeah, see y'all next time.
Let's try out this AC. I didn't even try it yet. Oh, yeah. It's already cold.
Sweet. We better get to the gas station, though.
So here we go, we got it out on the road. Let's see if this thing shifts. So far so good. We've gone through first, second, we're in third now. I think we got it, man. Brakes are good. Thank God, I almost missed my turn. All right, so here we go, getting it up on the highway. Let's see how she does. We got about, let's say, a 60 mile drive to get back to the lot. We should know everything we need to know about this thing by the end of that. So here we go. All right, everybody, we're about 20 miles into our trip back home and nothing to report. Cruising along, doing about 65, got the cruise set. AC's blasting, everything's working, radio works and everything. So far so good. I'm gonna have to jump off the highway here in just a minute and go to the AutoZone. I got a part I need to get for my Whip 150. She's sucking air. She got a vacuum leak, and I gotta get a manifold gasket for it. So we will take a quick little stop, and then we'll be back on the road again. All right, so I've got my parts. We are out of here. All right, here comes the moment of truth. Will it start again after 40 miles of driving? Let's see. Fire right up, gotta love it. All right, so we're on the last leg of our trip home. Another 20 miles to go, like I said before, and so far so good. Let's see what happens.
This guy to get us caught up in the middle of the parade. I think everybody in the whole town is here.
I didn't think we was ever gonna get through that. That was the Blanchard Homecoming Day Parade. I didn't know that was going on. I wouldn't even have went that way. That took a while.
We're just about to the lot. Figure I'd pull over right quick, give you guys a nice little walk around of what this thing looks like. In case you didn't see before, we're gonna get in a little more detail this time.
Okay, we're gonna do a little voiceover action here. For some reason, my mic keeps giving me issues. It cuts in and out and gets staticky, and I don't find out till it's too late. So, like we mentioned before, got an 08 Chevy Uplander, 264,000 miles, but it's been very well kept. It doesn't have any issues at all that I can tell. I've put close to 60 miles on it so far. Nothing was wrong at all. So, somebody kept up on it very well. I'm impressed with it. As you can see, the interior is pretty clean. No major stains, anything like that. Even back here in the back, which typically is the dirtiest part because, you know, you've been hauling around kids for 11 years, stands to reason it's going to get pretty dirty, but this one doesn't seem to be like that. I mean, it's got the DVD, it's got the little TV screen in the back, everything. Even back here at the very back, super clean. Got some stuff there from AutoZone for my little pickup truck at home. All the sliding doors, no problems. They don't hang up or anything. Underneath the hood's a little dirty, so we will detail that, get it nice and clean. We're definitely going to be buffing out those headlights.
All right, so we've officially made it back to the house with no issues. Awesome. Gotta like that. I mean, $1,000 car that you could drive all the way home, no problems. AC blowing, ice cold, cruise control set. That's great. I mean, is it perfect? No, absolutely not. It's a
It's a car with 264,000 miles on it, but somebody took care of it. It's highway miles, and it don't look like they've had a bunch of kids bouncing around in the back for the past 11 years. So I don't know if this was like maybe some kind of a fleet vehicle, maybe. Sometimes, you know, these old plain white vehicles, that's usually what they were. Some kind of a company vehicle, I don't know. Do a little research to find out. But I think I could get $1,800 for this thing all day long. It's been well maintained, taken care of. I don't see why not. So that's what we're going to shoot for. We'll get these headlights buffed out, give it a nice, I'll probably just run it by the car wash, get the numbers off the windshield, all that good stuff, shine it up a little bit, and up for sale she goes. Minimal effort on this one. Let's see if we can make a quick buck. So now that we've got the headlights done, what I was thinking is we would come in on here. As you can see, it's missing the little inlay that goes on this emblem. And I guess that's glue. Yeah, that's some kind of a silicone. I'm going to go through and just peel all that off. It's coming off pretty easy, just my fingernail. I'm going to clean all that off and see if I can't make this look a little bit better. Maybe we can make it look like nothing's missing. I don't know. We'll see. Left over from doing the Mariner, so we didn't even have to buy. We already bought this. This is already bought and paid for from the other flip, so technically we didn't even have to buy anything so far. Everybody, so the Uplander is ready for sale. She's all cleaned up, ready to go. I think I'm gonna ask around $2,000 on that one. You guys tell me what y'all think. What do you guys think that's worth in your area? In my area, I think probably around $2,000. We'll see if we can get at least $1,750, maybe $1,800 for it. Not bad for all we had to do was just shine up some headlights and wash it. So quick, easy money on that one. You guys want to know about the Mariner? Paid $1,400 for it. We spent about $20 cleaning it, a good, you know, day or two scrubbing it down, some good elbow grease, all that good stuff. Sold it for $3,900. Man, that was a hell of a flip. Awesome deal. Easy, you know, just took a little bit of work cleaning it up. You guys watch the video. If you haven't, go back and check it out. We took the seats out of it and everything. We really scrubbed that one down. But hey, $3,900 on that one. That was a hell of a flip. But I got to get going. I still have to put my gaskets in the 4OF F-150, or the F-1 Nifty as we call it around here. So I got to get this done. Hey, please like, share, subscribe. Check out my Instagram. I really appreciate all you guys watching. And we'll keep these flips coming at you. And don't forget about that little girl in there. We got a lot of work left to do on that one. And I just went down and bought some supplies for it. So we're going to get that one out real quick. So all you guys asking about the old Datsun pickup, get ready. I'm going to get you guys a video out on that one in the next day or two. Lots of cutting left on that one. So anyway, I'm out of here, man. Appreciate you guys. See y'all next time.